Love isn't just a word, it's an action. Love is involuntary. The ancient Greeks called love the madness of the gods. Love means so many different things to so many different people. Love is reaching your dreams together. Love is the connection of two hearts, the bearing of your soul, and the acceptance of another. It means the world to both of them that you are here to witness their wedding vows and celebrate their marriage. So I invite you to leave behind the worries and concerns of everyday life and join us in this celebration of love.
Torn down, full of aching, somehow our youth would take the blame. Worn out, the way we let it stay.
Wow!
Look at you!
How's your morning been?
Good, just
wow.
Yeah, you know.
Love it, yeah, it's coming.
This is an old Gaelic blessing for the married couple. Bal o yarav, o hawan balala brija, o lala brija gabaltana, o valtana gulunasa. Is o lunasa gusawan. Bua rahayiv, bua mak gus ininapiliv. Bua mara is chiriyiv. Bua gra yiv, bua jilchiyiv. Bua flahish yev, bua le is ihe yev. Mahas mara yev, mahas talav yev, mahas neve yev. Gachla sunny yev, garna adama yev. Uno is adam yev, gra gach ene yev.
Now you will feel no storms, for each of you will be sheltered to the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth to the other. Now there is no loneliness, for each of you is companion to the other. You are two persons, but there is one life before you, and one hope. Turn together to look at the road you have traveled to reach this, your hour of happiness. It stretches into the bound. Now look at the future that lies ahead, a long, winding, adventure-filled road whose every turn means new discovery, new hopes, new joys, new laughter, and a few shared tears. May happiness be your companion. May beauty surround you both in the journey ahead and through all the years to come. Go this day to your dwelling place and enter into your days together. May your days be good and long upon the earth. Your adventure has just begun.
Before you, Matt and Rebecca are joined together in the presence of God, my presence, and in the presence of these witnesses. I am bound, as you know, to remind you publicly of the solemn, the seriousness, binding nature of the relationship into which you are now about to enter. Marriage, as most of us understand it, is a voluntary and full commitment of two people to each other. It is made in the deepest sense to the exclusion of all others and is entered into with the desire, the hope, and the firm intention it will last a lifetime. Matt, do you take Rebecca in marriage to be your wedded wife, to share your life as your friend, your lover, your companion, to grow together in spirit and in truth and in forsaking all others?
I do.
And do you, Rebecca, take Matt in marriage to be your wedded husband, to share your life as your friend, your lover, your companion, to grow together in spirit and in truth and in forsaking all others?
I do.
Can we have the rings, please, Joshua? This is where you both get to make a personal wish on your wedding rings before you exchange them. The ring is an ancient symbol, so perfect and simple. It has no beginning and has no end. It is a circle, for love that is given comes back around again. Your rings are precious because you wear them with love. They symbolize your commitment and marriage. They remind you of who you are, where you have been, and where you are going. As you wear them through time, they will reflect not only who you are as individuals, but who you are as a couple.
I take you, Rebecca,
to be my wife.
I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, and I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
I take you, Matt, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, and I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
Matt and Rebecca have declared before us they will live together in marriage. They have made special promises to each other. They have symbolized it by taking vows and exchanging rings. So therefore, on your behalf and on behalf of the community and in the sight of God, I now declare them to be husband and wife. Matt, you may kiss your bride.
Matt, you just look so right beside Rebecca. And when anyone is choosing a companion to walk through life, I could not have put two people better matched than you two. I'm so, so happy to have you into the family. And we are in the hallowed halls of the living legends, the rock and roll legends. So nothing is going to be quiet, nothing is going to be serious, nothing like my daughter is conventional. So I want you to kick up your heels, raise a little hell, and start by raising your glasses and wishing all the wealth and health in the world to Rebecca and Matt.
Take a few moments to talk about my gorgeous wife. I'm sure you'll all agree she looks absolutely gorgeous today. Even more so than usual, and that's saying something. So when I first saw Rebecca at the aforementioned brunch in Dubai, I remember thinking to myself, wow. So as Graham was saying earlier, the whole place was packed, and true to form, I was running a little bit late. And as I sat down and introduced myself and we got talking, I remember thinking to myself how charming and erudite and witty she was, not to mention gorgeous.
And as Graham said earlier, we struck up a friendship which quickly developed, and fast forward a few years, and here we are today. So, when it came time to propose, I gave it a lot of thought for how I wanted to do it. Should it be in a romantic restaurant? Should it be on top of the Burj Khalifa in Dubai? Should it be on a romantic weekend retreat? All of which were good options. But in the end, it seemed most appropriate to get down on bended knee at somewhere very special to Rebecca, that's somewhere very close to her heart. So that's why I went down on one knee on top of a windswept mountain on Akwell Island, where Rebecca's family comes from. So, we're on the island for 3 days only. We're on holiday over from Dubai. And I thought to myself, no problem. Day one, get in, get settled, relax, sign myself up. Day two, gonna pop the question. So of course day one comes and we arrive, the sun is shining, it's June, beautiful day. I think, yeah, I'll do it tomorrow, it'll be fine, I'll do it tomorrow. It's summer in Ireland, what can go wrong? So sure enough, day two dawns, torrential rain and gale force winds. And I remember thinking to myself at the time, oh crap. See, I didn't really have a plan B. I was kind of going for the on top of the mountain. That was plan A and the only plan. So I was praying that the weather gods would be kind to me. And when day three, our last chance, final day on the island came, the weather would be good. So I went to bed that night feeling slightly nervous, slightly tense, slightly drunk. So day three dawns and I'm looking out the window straight away at first light. It's a good sign. The rain has stopped. The weather has dropped down from hurricane force to merely cyclonic. So I drag Rebecca downstairs, throw breakfast down and looking out the window, come on, let's go get some fresh air. Just quick, bundle her into the car and off we went before the weather could change. She must have thought, what the hell was going on? Anyway, when we get there, we drive up to the top of the mountain. I've got it all planned out. I'll get my phone out on top of the mountain and call her over and we'll take a selfie with the beautiful backdrop of the island behind us. Great, it's all gonna go. And I'll get down on one knee and I'll pop the question while she's there. Unfortunately, due to my haste and due to my nerves, I left my phone in the car and my brain in the glove compartment. So when I said, come on over for a sec, with me, okay. Fortunately, Rebecca had hers with her. And in the end, all's well that ends well, and we took the selfie, and I got down on bended knee, and a few moments later, she made me the happiest man on the planet when she said yes. Darling, I'm very proud to call myself your husband, and I'm very proud to call you my wife, and I love you very much.
Mr. and Mrs. Easttown.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore. When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore. Bells will ring, ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling, and you'll sing the Vita Bella. Hearts will play, tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay, like a guitarandella. When the stars make you drool, just like a pastifazool, that's amore. When you dance down the street with a cloud at your feet, you're in love. When you walk in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, signore. Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Press the bridal party on the floor tonight, everybody!
That's amore.
When ding-a-ling,
ding-a-ling-a-ling.
And you sing Vita Bella.
Vita Bella, Vita Bella. Hearts will play.
Tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay.
Like a gay tarantella.
Despite all my best intentions, always seem to come up short, but I cannot escape your grace, oh God. Because of your relationship.